Alright, on to the last part.
Well, not last part, last world.
And by the way, guys, if you think the camera looks a little different, I've figured out things with the camera stand, so now it doesn't have to be looking straight up at Mike's TV. I have it level now. I'm so excited about it.
You should have seen them before the camera went live.
Before I hit record, I was like a little kid getting so excited. Oh my god, I learned new features about a camera stand.
I believe the exact words are, I'm so excited.
Yeah, I know, right?
Meanwhile, anyone who's watching this is like, dork, get a capture card instead. Because that's basically what it is.
This is when Sly puts two and two together and realizes, oh shit, Clockwork might actually be an enemy of my ancestors.
Hey, Sly! The road to Clockwork's fortress is blocked! Do me a favor and shoot out that lock for me, would you, pal?
Oh, they did the oddball thing where it's like...
inverted and pressing the circle button to shoot?
Square.
Oh, that's even worse.
See, I'm sorry, but Kenny, you've been saying oddball so much tonight, I'm like, are these things really oddball, though?
See, that's what I hate most about shooting stuff like this. Like, I want up to be up and down to be down, thank you very much.
Yeah, I hate inverted.
I don't mind.
Okay.
You like
don't pause it, don't pause it, it's cool. If it dies on us, it dies on us.
If what dies on us?
The controller, because it's in the battery as well.
We have a charger we can plug into it first.
And it's
hey. Oh, fuck these things, by the way. These are the worst part of this particular mission.
Yeah.
Get ready when they hit, yeah, when they hit fire, that's the easiest time to hit them, but at the same time, they can hit you.
Oh my god, I was gonna say, did you say I was a weirdo because I actually like inverted sometimes?
Yeah, because you like your controls wrong.
I like how you can actually shoot the boulders before they come down.
Oh yeah, that makes it so much easier.
No, my thing is, I don't mind inverted in some cases. It just depends on the game.
Heads up! The Robo Falcons are back!
Ah, I hate inverted!
You know what I hate? Robo Falcons. You know, I didn't even notice it in the opening credits when I was a kid when I played this game. I didn't know Clockwork was actually a robot.
Okay.
How did you do that? How the hell did you do that?
Because I got mad skills, yo.
Yeah, man, mad skills, boy!
Look at how big boulders!
Like when he did that 900? That was way off the chain, yo!
White people. Making life unfun since the dawn of time.
Yeah, I was gonna be like... because I was quoting an old Tony Hawk game for the Wii. Brownie points if anyone knows specifically which one.
Was it Ride?
No. Fuck that shit.
If it was a Tony Hawk game for the Wii, I thought of it. But what Tony Hawk game?
Damn, I wanted to make the people guess, but people probably won't watch, so I have to say it. Downhill Jam. Which wasn't that bad.
Oh yeah, Ride wasn't even on.
I think it was.
Sorry.
Yeah, Ride and Shred were on the Wii, actually.
I'm sorry, I gotta give you a round of applause for that, Kenny. With all the bitching you did, you didn't even take a hit. And we unfortunately lose the gun here.
But the point I was gonna make is...
oh, yay.
Like I said, I'd rather do that than this.
The joke I was gonna make when I mentioned that line from Tony Hawk Downhill Jam. That was way off the chain, yo! Me. White people, right?
I was actually, I myself was quoting the Nostalgia Critic, so you're right.
Yeah, I know, but still. The point I was gonna make is, actually, Downhill Jam was, for one of the, like, post-underground Tony Hawk games, it wasn't that bad. Because, can we lower this a little? I feel like I'm screaming over it.
Sure, where is the reverse? Sorry. Here you
go, man. Outward. Cool, thanks.
Go! Why such an oddball number?
What number?
Because Clockwork...
119.
Is that your word of the day, by the way, Kenny? Oddball?
Yes.
it's on his word of the day calendar.
But yeah, I was gonna say, with Downhill Jam, that was like the last... one of the last, like, decent post-Underground Tony Hawk games. Because after the Underground series, the series kind of just veered off into insanity.
And deteriorated to...
insanity, weirdness, and whatever the fuck Tony Hawk Pro Skater 5 was. Which, actually, you can't play anymore.
Wait, what?
I think it's one of those games where it had to be online, but they shut down the servers for it. So now, basically, I think if you get the game, it's just nothing.
Which hey, I'm sorry, I can't see my computer from here. How many do I have?
You have
35.
36.
Really?
36 now, yeah.
But the point I was making is that Pro Skater 5, if you get it now, it's basically nothing, but I almost feel like that's better than what you would actually get with the game.
You mean one of the more of nothing?
One of the few games where nothing is better than something.
I can name a couple of games that are like that.
I'm listening.
Sonic 06.
Yeah, but nothing would have been better than something there.
Sonic and the Black Knight.
Yeah, I didn't like that game. I know some people do, but I don't.
Sonic and the Secret Rings.
Right, is this just all going to be Sonic games? And actually, I didn't mind Secret Rings.
Sorry, you're asking a Sonic fan and Sonic hater at the same time.
A game that sounded would have been better or nothing.
Nothing
would have
been better than something.
Nothing would have been better than something.
Aliens Colonial Marines?
There you go. Honestly, I think I
would. Funny enough, I actually played that. Didn't mind it too much for the simplicity of what it was, but.
Oh, fuck this part.
For anything else, yeah, Colonial Marines would have been a lot better if it was handled right.
It's Carmelita. She looks trapped.
And the dumb part is that they try to, like, retcon a lot of shit that happened in the movies.
Don't you hate that, though, when it's a licensed video game based around a licensed property?
Yeah.
And they fuck with the story.
Very much.
I was gonna say, though, at least in Colonial Marines' case, at least they did the aliens license right the next year with Isolation.
Well, that was also learning from a mistake that shouldn't have been made.
But also another thing.
I was going to say, Isolation is a game that, like, it got good reviews when it came out, but I feel like the game has aged quite nicely.
Oh, nicely, okay.
Because I feel like I hear a lot of people say that it's actually a pretty great game now.
I would be definitely afraid to play that game at all.
Yeah, that's why I was going to say, I think it aged nicely because of how unique the enemy AI was.
You mean where it can just do whatever it wanted and not care if you're hiding or not?
Yeah, where it was just...
No, you can hide the whole time and it'd still get you.
Yeah, that's the scary part.
Where it was absolutely freaking unpredictable in, like, one of the most unique of ways.
Jump up on the table, mate. Jump on the table. There you go.
I'm gonna go around.
I figured you saw the sparkles.
Yeah, I don't know why you didn't see the sparkles.
Oh!
Oh, man. Yeesh.
Can I hit that?
Yeah, cool.
You have to hit that. Supposed to, yeah.
We're gonna give the banjo player a workout here.
Is it a banjo?
But
whatever they're playing with.
Something like that. But you've watched the original Alien and Aliens.
Actually, no, I haven't.
No, I haven't seen any of the Aliens movies.
Okay, then. Do you ever plan to watch it?
Maybe one day. I'm not really a horror person, so...
Do you want me to tell you the thing they tried to fix in Colonial Marines?
No, because I don't want you to spoil it for the people.
Well, Colonial Marines, like, almost nobody's gonna play, and if you haven't watched Aliens...
Wait, did I just get through that on my first try?
Yes.
This is a good run.
I actually am unbelievably proud of myself, because I always fucking fail that shit.
This is a good run, we gotta keep this up.
I'm gonna knock on wood.
So, what's your, gripe about, me spoiling what happens in Colonial Marines?
I guess he doesn't want you ruining the story of the movies
for the people!
I mean, it's a they're a 40-year-old
the movies,
movie, Matt.
Yeah, the movies
don't
are old as shit.
Okay, fine. What did they try to fix then?
Alright, so... After Colonial Marines and something... I'm trying to, like, focus and tell something at the same time and doing poorly. So, like, one of the characters that survives in, Aliens, kind of turns out that he was, like, infected and, like, died or something like that, and in actuality, he did.
You can't kill him, Kenny.
Oh, you can't? Okay.
Kenny, this whole Let's Play, has been trying to kill things that you probably shouldn't kill. I think Kenny's just got some killer instinct in him.
That's another game series I think nothing would be better
also,
than.
Also, I'm kind of like...
No, I don't think so. Killer Instinct 2013 was pretty good.
If not released unfinished on purpose.
Even if it was released unfinished. But then again, even unfinished, it was probably the best launch day exclusive on the Xbox One. I don't know if that says... If that speaks to its quality or the lack of quality of the other launch games, but you know.
I say yes to that.
Ah!
No, you're not dead! You're not dead! You're not dead!
No, my lucky charm.
It's only one, though.
They're after me, lucky charms.
Yummy.
But they are after me, lucky charms. Why did everyone laugh when I say that?
It's a television commercial. I'm not gonna do the whole spiel with
Austin Powers 3.
Oh, this is candy. I'm having fun. Wait, 3? I thought it was 1.
No,
you jinxed it!
3. That's what would have been better than nothing.
Also, my hand is really busted up right now, so... Yeah,
that's why we weren't sure, but... You can do it, Kenny. Just remember, you clutched out Ms. Ruby in 3 tries. You got this.
Matt, shut up.
I'm the one.
Jinx!
Every MCU game. Nothing would have been better than those games.
MCU?
Yeah, the Marvel Cinematic Universe.
Yeah. I was gonna be that guy and call technicality and be like, but Spider-Man, but that's not.
None of the Spider-Man games they ever made were based around the MCU.
Wait. Okay, cool.
It's one of those things that counts zero as a number. Well done, Kenny.
Yeah.
You see, I told you you could clutch it out. Way to go.
And this is the only time you ever kind of like go backwards to a level?
Yeah, it's because he had to wake up.
I'll make it up to you somehow. Okay.
Well, it wasn't very strong to begin with. I'm sorry, what time are we at? I don't know.
Only 11 minutes.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
We've been getting through this quick.
And not only that, this is the very last level of Sly 1, so... And it's just a straight run.
Yeah.
We're not doing any collectibles, no anything like that. Why? Just straight run.
And again, I'm going to point it out, I'm very proud of my run on that last mission, because I usually always fail that somewhere, but that was like first try, just boop!
I was going to say, if I may Sly out for a few minutes before we talk about other topics.
Whatever.
Clockwork is the main antagonist of the entire series, if we all agree to that, right?
Yeah.
Because he's the basis for everything that kind of happens.
Only 1 and 2. After 2.
Yeah, but at the same time, after 2, his presence is still felt in 3 because bleep bleep is now bleep bleep because of what happened.
You'd have to. Tell me after.
Alright, well, anyway, if you think about it, we still know very little about Clockwork. Because we don't know where he came from, we don't know how he spent thousands of years staying alive. And we don't know what technology he used in the thousands of years before to keep himself alive, or why he hates the Cooper so much. It's like there's a throwaway line that says he was jealous of them, but jealous of them for what? The fact that they were thieves?
He wanted to be the greatest thief.
I want to remind you we're playing a kid's game, so the story isn't going to be that deep.
Yeah, but at the same time, I'm as an adult, I'm asking why? Like, I always wondered why the Coopers, though. Did a specific Cooper fuck him over, is what I'm saying.
I mean, if he killed him, it would have to be Sly's dad.
Sly's dad couldn't have done anything personal with Clockwork.
Clockwork has been around for much longer.
If we actually go all the way to Sly 4 right now, he's been around since Bob's time, which is, like, even before Christ. So, yeah. Like, what did he do? What did the Coopers do to Clockwork that made him hate him so much?
Oh, wait, isn't this the platforming part?
Oh, yeah, this is the fun part.
I remember in the last Let's Play, I failed here a lot, so pray for me.
And I have no lucky charms.
I might be able to do this if you don't feel confident.
No, I can do it. We're going in order. I have to brave this out. Let's go!
I feel like when you get to the jetpack, we're gonna have to do a hard cut, though.
What do you mean?
Because I don't know how much time we have after this.
We'll see. We'll see how many tries it takes me, so.
This is, like, a good platforming challenge, though. The whole place is sinking, and it's like, everything Sly learned has to be put to the test now. Yeah, Kenny? You said, wait a minute.
Do I actually get Clockwork as the boss?
Yes, you do.
Hey! Are you thanking God for that, or are you upset?
My skills may be put to the test.
I was gonna say, you didn't have to jump. I made a mistake.
I'm not saying you made a mistake.
I'm stressed.
Come on, Matt. You can do it.
You might have been able to jump over that. You have to keep jumping.
Yeah, this is where they fuck with you, Matt. Come on.
Guys, I'm stressed. I feel my heart racing.
Come on. You can do it. Your palms are sweaty. Knees are weak, arms are heavy.
Something about mom's spaghetti? His palms spaghetti, knees weak, mom's spaghetti. There's vomit on his mom's spaghetti. Mom's spaghetti. I thought I was gonna miss that.
Oh my god. Can you do it?
Don't jinx me!
You know, I have a buddy who, that's his catchphrase every time something happens. Oh my god, oh my fucking god. Come on, man, move! Come on.
Hey,
oh, my God. Wait. Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, oh my God. God. Oh, yes. Yes. No.
Jeremy.
I like how the tower, like, every time you die, starts ascending back up.
That's great.
Oh, my God. That was so...
Man.
Oh my God. I bet I was right there too.
You were.
You were. You literally only had to go through that and you were there. Bro, I am like, dude, you were this close.
Well, hopefully this run will be better because you know what they say, you have to hit rock bottom to know how it feels.
Well, that is true.
Yeah.
You might be able to jump over this one too.
I
didn't want to take the risk.
Honestly, I feel like that right there is what got you the last time that you waited.
Yeah. Like, waiting at all really kills you on this run.
Well, I mean...
By the way, Kenny, you're kind of right. I find it funny that the tower ascends when you die.
Yeah, it's one of the weirdest things I noticed when I was a kid. I'm like...
I think it's the game I think it's the game's way of reloading the level so that you don't have to sit through a long load time.
I'm sorry, I had to wait there. I don't think I could jump over that.
But then again, this game wasn't known for long load times, was
now,
it?
I'm just thinking of an excuse, Kenny. I'm thinking of an excuse. Because otherwise, why is the temple re-rising?
Well, it's not a temple. But...
Whatever you want to call it. Come on, man. You can do it. Go. Perfect. And now jump.
Here?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I think finally stopped.
Okay. What time are we at?
Like... 16 minutes.
Oh, we might have time to squeeze this in.
Yeah, you got 13 minutes to do it.
Oh god, the inverted controls. Ah.
That was really tensing for me. I'm still proud of myself because two tries. I think when I did the last Let's Play, because I was the one playing it, I think it took me about 12. So two is a marked improvement for me. Especially given that the first one was that close.
But we're having the revelation.
Yeah, that he's been fighting the Koopas for years. Well, you can't eat anything else. You're a robot.
He eats jealousy. I eat jealousy for breakfast. But seem to create holes in his armor.
Shoot into the gaps I create. All right, how does it not hurt him but creates holes in his armor? That literally makes no sense, Carmelita.
How do you know the fight just started?
Yeah, I know, right?
Clockwork, the world's biggest owl, who is actually, if I look at his Wikipedia, this might actually be the first time in a minute I'm looking at any Wikipedia page for the Sly Cooper characters.
Oh my God, inverted controls.
But according to this, he's the world's largest what is that word?
European?
Eurasian.
He's a Eurasian eagle owl, which is a very weird combination of birds.
Entirely.
And he was born before 10,000 BC.
Wait, why is there a giant head of him? Oh, wait, that's the tower.
Because that's the tower, yes.
I was going to say, why is there a giant head when his head just fell in?
Because like every Sly Cooper villain, he's very, very egomaniacal. You must have known my father had a son.
If you hated the Cooper soul... You know who else is an egomaniac? I hate to spoil part of Sly 3, but Tony the Killer Bee. He's a terror to every playground from here to Sicily.
According to this, his voice actor is Ross Douglas.
Tough, funny guy.
I actually was telling Mike this, but I was watching videos of, like, the beta of Sly 3, which is amazing in so many dumb ways, because, like, one, the story just sounds like bad fanfic, but also because, like, they don't actually have dialogue, it's just, like, text-to-speech. Apparently in the original version, you weren't supposed to find what his nickname was, you had to find the name of his mother.
Oh.
Which would have been weird if his friends actually knew what his mother's name was. Well, co-workers.
Well, I was about to say, actually not really, but...
Well, if you're only there to work and you're not there to make friends, you know?
Well, yeah.
But it's funny, because that footage is just, like, it's awesome in just so many dumb ways. Because it just...
Like, it's not the actual actors doing the character's voice, it's just people dubbing over what the...
No, it's not even people, it's robots. Because it's text-to-speech.
You can show me this at some point.
It's like if you go on Google Translate, type something in, and then hit the button, it's basically like one of those robotic voices saying it.
That's crazy.
And again, the story basically is about the same quality as a really bad Sonic fanfic, just without, you know, sex.
Where is she shooting from?
No idea.
A safe distance.
From what I read, his Clockwork is voiced by Ross Douglas, who voices John Basson in Sly 2.
Huh.
This is also the only time we ever hear Clockwork speak either, so it doesn't really matter much. Because he doesn't talk at all in Sly 2, because you know. Well, either way, now it's the biggest platforming challenge ever.
See, I'm proud of myself for that joke. Where is she? Where is she shooting from? A safe distance?
Now, here's the worst part of this fight.
No!
Matt. Oh, Kenny, pause.
Are we cutting?
Yeah, there is no way.
I was so close.